Good morning, brothers and sisters. Morning. We welcome you to the service of thanksgiving for our brother Theophilus Jemmott. So as we begin this worship service, our opening hymn will be Hymn to God Be the Glory on page 2 of your leaflets. You may stand as you're able to.
To God be the glory, great things he hath done. So loved he the world that he did Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath done.
Great things he hath taught us.
Great things he hath taught us. Great things he hath done. How great our rejoicing through Jesus the Son.
But purer
and higher and greater will be our wonder, our rapture, when Jesus speaks.
We'll praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. And praise the Lord. Oh, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, and praise the Lord, let the people rejoice.
Oh, come to the Father, to Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath.
Amen. You may be seated, friends. So let us go to God in prayer. Let us pray. Most gracious God, we turn to you in the sorrow and grief of this moment, praying that we may find the strength we need in you, Lord, so that even as we mourn the death of one whom we knew and loved, that we may be not overcome by this trial, Lord, but we may hold fast, trusting in your goodness and in your mercy. Assure us, O Lord, that death is not the end of those who trust in you. And may our hearts be so composed by your Holy Spirit that all fear and bitterness may be swallowed up by your love and peace that you give to all your troubled children. Through Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, who by your Holy Spirit you minister to us in our weakness, O Lord, and by the victory of your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us the pledge of eternal life. We pray that during this present stress and sorrow, that you would shed the light of your glory and grace upon us. Through Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We are met in this solemn moment to commend Theophilus Jemmott into the hands of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who sent his Son Jesus Christ to be our Redeemer, by whose stripes we are healed, and in whose name alone do we have salvation. Let us then recall to mind the life of our dear brother, and in humble trust hear the words of Holy Scripture. So friends, there will be a slight change to the program. We'll now have the eulogy, which will be done by Sister Gloria Whitaker.
Good morning to one and all. I thank you all for attending service this morning. My father, Theophilus Jemmott, was born on the 24th of October, 1926, in the parish of St. Michael's, in Paris Gap, West Bay Road, and he was known to many as Coxon. He was the sixth of 10 children and was the father of 2 children, Gloria, myself, and Liam. I am the firstborn, and when I remember my mother telling me when I was born, he told all of his friends that I was the world in arms. He's got the world in arms. He was employed as a casual worker at the General Post Office, and in those days, his job was to bring the mail from various cruise ships In those days, they didn't have meals. They didn't meal the coming by plane. They come from the cruise ships. So he worked with that, the meals from the cruise ships. He was a newspaper vendor also. At first, in Trafalgar Square years ago. And then in Marhill Street later, many years. And finally, at his home in Barts Road. Until physical challenges made it impossible to continue. My father was a caring person who never shirked away from his responsibilities. I remember my father many years on Sundays, we always had to have a treat, and Daddy would make sure that we had chocolate and things like that. On Christmas, he would always provide that, he made sure we had what was provided, and we also had our school clothes, whatever he did provide. He may not be since all of that kind of something he would give away, but he never made a lot of sport, but he always provided for us. He never left us up. He was a father. And I took care of him myself at home until he was admitted to geriatric hospital. Until his death on the 5th of May, may he rest in peace. I think that God had saw he was getting weary and he took him home. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Gloria. Very good.
So now, friends, we'll have the ministry of the word and we'll have our first lesson, which is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 51 to 58, which will be read by Olivia Wilson. After which, we'll have the second lesson, which is taken from John 14, 1 to 6 and verse 27, which will be read by Charisse Wilson.
Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be all changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law.
Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except me. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Here ends the reading.
So now, brothers and sisters, we'll have a short reflection on God's word, which was taken to us from the Gospel of John. So let us pray. O Lord, as we're about to break your spoken word, make our hearts in tune and attune, that God, we may be able to receive your peace and know that you're always with us. Through Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Jesus said, peace I leave with you, not as the world gives. Friends, peace. Today we are met to say goodbye to our loved one, Theophilus. And now is a time when we may be feeling a bit shaken up. And with everything that is going on in the world, we can even say that it's a time of a shaky period. But I want for us to know that Jesus said that there is peace for us. Jesus went to his disciples right before he was about to die. And no doubt this would have been a shaky time for them to lose their master and their friend. And Jesus said to them, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, but also believe in me. And what Jesus was saying was that you have to, in order to have peace, you must have proper perspective. No doubt at that time, to lose someone that the disciples would have loved would have been hard. And no doubt it would have been natural for them to feel troubled or to feel sad. But Jesus said, do not let your heart be troubled. But what Jesus meant here, friends, was not that they should not cry, was not that they should not feel sad, but that they should have their perspective on God, because it is with God that everything will be all right. He said to
believe in him and also to believe in God. And right now, as we lay to rest Theophilus, no doubt we may be feeling sad. We may be wondering what is there next to life. We may be even wondering what is there next with God. But I want to let you know that there is peace for you. And that peace is in the perspective of God. You may have questions. You may wonder why would God do certain things. And all of that is fine, friends. All of these hard questions are okay to have. But know that we can always trust in God. Know that no matter what, we have to keep looking to God. And to know that God has our best interest at heart. Secondly, there is peace in God's promises. Jesus said, I am going to prepare a place for you so that where I am, there you may be also. And so Jesus was talking to the disciples about the life after death and the fact that he was preparing a place for them to go when they would die. And surely after losing a friend like Jesus, they may wonder to themselves, what is next for me? What is next in my life? And so to today, we might be wondering, what next after Theophilus? What next after losing someone that I love? And I want you to know that there is peace in the promise of God. Jesus said that I'm going to prepare a place for you. And that lets us know that Jesus is still working in our lives. It lets us know that even though now it might seem hard and now it might seem as if all is lost, Jesus is still working. That life is not over. We may not have all the answers. We may not know what is next to come. But we know that Jesus is working things through. That as a family, now is a time for you all to band together. That now is a time to know that it's okay not to know what next to do. But to know that despite it all, that God is still in control. And lastly, Jesus said for us to be the people of peace. Jesus said, peace I leave with you, my peace, not as the world gives. And so Jesus here is trying to show them that he is the source of peace. That in that moment of struggle, that Jesus is someone that they can look to for support. And so too for us today, friends, we have to be people of peace. It is hard for brothers and sisters when life comes, when we lose a loved one, when things are shaky. And we may wonder, who is there to help me? We may wonder, why is these things happening now? But what Jesus is showing us is that as we rely on him, it gives us the strength to be someone that people can rely on. You know, very often in life, we might say, well, who is there for me? Who is there to wipe away my tears? Who is there? But brothers and sisters, if everyone believes that he or she is crying, or everyone believes or is looking for someone to lead, then as a unit, we may not be able to move forward. But if we were able to trust God and to rely on God's strength and to realize that there's strength within us to be able to be the one who persons can turn to, then we will be able to fulfill what God wants us to be. We may not have all the answers, brothers and sisters. We may not know what to do next, but we know that once we compose ourselves, once we be honest with God, and once we be honest with those around us, we can be that person of peace. That even as we cry, we can tell someone it'll be okay. Even as we may not know what tomorrow will hold, we can let them know that we are there with them. And even if we may have times where our faith is wavering, we can let someone know that God is still with us and that God still cares. So peace. So know Jesus, brothers and sisters, by your perspective. Know that God is with us. Know Jesus by his promises and know that he is still working in your life. And know that we should be people of peace that someone can turn to for strength and for hope. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So now we'll invite Joyce Charles to bring a tribute. I stood in all the Jerusalem beside the temple there. be to you, O God, our Father, who created us in your own image for eternal fellowship with you. Praise and thanksgiving to you, O Christ, our Lord and God, who have overcome the sharpness of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers, and are now seated at the right hand of God with the Father in glory. Praise and blessing be to you, O Holy Spirit, God our Comforter, who bear witness within us of the acceptance with the Father and have become the pledge of our eternal inheritance. All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We bless your name for the life of him who we laid today to rest, Lord. We give you thanks for the joy and blessing of his life and what it has brought to others, for his service to his generation according to your will, and for every happy remembrance of his life. We bless you for your mercy and goodness which has followed him all the days of his life, that now the trials of this world are over and death itself is past. Receive him into your perfect kingdom and bring us with all who have lived and served you faithfully to the fullness of your eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So friends, we will have the commendation, so I invite us to stand as we're able to. Eternal God, who have made us all and who hate nothing that you have made, and have given your Son for our redemption, we commend our brother Theophilus Gemot to your perfect mercy and wisdom. Eternal rest grant upon him, and let perpetual light shine upon him. And we'll pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, the Our Father prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, we will now sing the hymn, And Can It Be? So we'll now begin our committal, brothers and sisters. We know that neither death nor life, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height or depth, nor any creature can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. We know that if this earthly house of our tabernacle be removed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Since our brother has departed out of this life, and Almighty God in his mercy has taken him unto himself, therefore we commit his body to the ground, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, earth to earth, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, from henceforth blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Let us pray. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all comfort, raise us up, we pray, from death of sin to the new life of righteousness, that when we shall depart from this life, we shall be found acceptable in your sight. This we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. He's the heir of salvation, the purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Changing scenes of life, in trouble and in joy, the praises of my God shall still my heart and my tongue employ. Through all the changing scenes of life, in troubles and in joy, the praises of heart and tongue employ. Oh, make a trial of his love, experience will decide. Oh, blessed are they. We'll sing the song, "O Love That Wilt Not Let Me Go."
Oh, hear the word of God once again. After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne, and the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one who knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are here before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eye." Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God, and they will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who is seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write these, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am Alpha and Omega. I am the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my people." So, brothers and sisters, as we have laid our brother to rest, let us receive the benediction. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Good morning to everyone. On behalf of the Gemma family, I give my great thanks and gratitude for you all coming this morning. I have to take time out from your work, but I am thankful very much. Thank you all.